Ad hoc loop today, cycling through Chipata. In fact, the plan was to cycle all the way up to the border, but I forgot my passport. I hope this thing won't break apart. I mean, I don't have a bike rack, so it was just a saddle here. I don't know how I forgot my passport, but actually thinking of driving all the way. For enjoying the fact that it's a holiday today. Yeah, this road is too cold for a natural road, but be doing this, but I just did. Right. Oh, I didn't know there was a church road here as well. Natural here, but I think I'm on the wrong lane here. Bike lane is the other side. Yeah, Malum. I don't know if I'll manage to get all the way up to the border here. Already tired. Yeah, it probably has something to do with the elevation, right? Yeah, it's the elevation. I'm beginning to regret my insane plan to cycle all the way up to Mwami border, right? 50 k's. Oh, like a total of 100 k's because I have to cover pretty much the same distance. It's a round trip. Ha! I'm taking it easy here because I so Google Maps can only show you so much, right? Well, at least I didn't bother to check the elevation. If I have time, I'll probably cycle through other parts of Chipata. Coming with the ascent here, the thing is not as effective as the MXR. Too late now though. goodness, I love this place. Chipata, that is. And yes, there are certain segments of the city that are far much better looking than what you're seeing right now. So again, I'm cycling towards the Zambia-Malawi border, right? The Mwami border. The right is Chadiza right there. This is Chadiza turn off anyway. Beginning to think that maybe I should have just done a bike tour of Chipata rather than cycling towards Mwami border. There aren't a lot of these slopes. Still is I didn't eat, right? I mean, mother did offer to prepare breakfast, but I told her I was fine. know, Chipata Trades set up shop here. It's kind of reassuring when you see people putting on masks further away from the central business district, right? Like the ascent is I can pedal as hard as I would want to, but I can only do so much, which is why I usually use this thing when I'm riding low, right? Riding low. Then again, I guess it just forces me to take things easy. And in the process, you know, I end up conserving energy, I suppose. I don't know what I'm doing here. Doesn't feel like I'm Wow. Again, I love, I love this place. I love Chipata. I mean, I don't claim to be a sort of person who's visited a ton of places around the world, but I've been around, and there's very few places I've been to, that is, where I would feel comfortable living long term, right? I mean, besides Chipata, I thought my trip to Lesotho back in 2012 had a lasting impression on me, right? I wouldn't mind living there long term. Spent many years in South Africa, and I definitely would not want to, you know, live long term that country, or at least a part of South Africa that I lived in, right? I'm not trying to generalize things here. I mean, I've heard a lot of good things about places like Eastern Cape, for instance. So I don't know, maybe I'd like it there or something. Yo, Marum. Yo. Yo, Nongeka. Mwalema. Mwapatari. Mwapatari. Oh. So that right there, yeah, I guess is proof that, you know, my taking my time here, cycling uphill here, is not because I'm lazy, but because it's quite steep, actually. It's cycling through the stretch is an uphill battle here. I'm guessing I should probably go back once I hit the 2-hour mark. I don't think cycling to Mwami is a good idea. Certainly not with this bike here. So if I do 2 hours, then I know I would have covered half the distance I normally cover when I'm home, right? Should be. Good a time as any to head back to my parents' house. I don't call it home, man. Yeah, well. You don't come across people who are as polite as he is in Lusaka. At least not in the part of Lusaka I stay in. Zikom. I know this is largely desolate, but I love this. I just noticed that I probably looked like a weirdo when I was cycling through that busy stretch of Umodzi Highway, right? I was the only cyclist putting on a helmet, yeah? Beautiful stuff. Little doggo looks malnourished. Wow. gentleman looks way older than my dad. And it looks like he's pushing that pedal like it's nothing, right? I guess people age differently. My father has trouble walking these days. He's only 67, but now this right here is the reason why I've earmarked Chipata as a retirement destination. It's all about quality, baby. Quality of life. Yeah, Malume. Kind of interesting how my my cultural inclination hasn't really gone away. I suppose it's like riding a bike. Yeah, once certain things are ingrained in you, they just they never go away, right? Like this yellow thing is almost like an involuntary reflex action, if you will. Yo. All right. Beautiful stuff. if I was in Chipata for long, I probably would have explored some of these nice looking areas, right? Just go deep into the interior and just check out what's there, I suppose. Yo. Thank you, Toyota Chipata. Yo. What the hell? Wow, UPND right there. Funny thing is, from Ruangwa all the way up to Chipata, or by the time I was getting to Petauke scene, it was getting dark, but all I could see were PF posters here. Yeah, was it on Marun Machoma? Bueno, it was supposed to be Mauka there. Strive, they say, strive, yeah? Yo! I'll be surprised if he's coming from Malawi, right? I had stock at the back. So at the time growing up, when most of the goods, right, commodities, even perishables actually, were fetched from Mchinji, right, which is closest city or town on the other side, right, the Malawi side. So people would cycle all the way to Mchinji and the long way and get, you know, things like soft drinks, you know, Coca-Cola and Fanta. But yeah, things have changed now. I mean, to a certain extent, our manufacturing industry has sort of like taken shape, right? It's almost like the opposite happens now, I think. Then also, I mean, if you look at it from a perspective of economies of scale, most goods can, most quality goods can easily be fetched from South Africa, right? And Zambia is much closer to South Africa than Malawi, I guess. I know my battery is going to die, so for you to kind of appreciate when it dies, I don't think I'll be able to take footage of me going in the opposite direction. So for you to appreciate where I'm coming from, I'm just going to circle around. There you go. That right there is where I'm coming from. I wonder if you can do that, Kasonde, right? I have to show you this so you tell us if you can. Yeah, oskom. Mauka. Skomo, yeah. That's probably a family right there. Life. Simplicity at its best. Now, I mean, you go online and there's a weird, I guess others would argue, interesting movements, like this minimalist movement. What I just cycled past is minimalism at its best right there. Sustainable living. Now, one would probably argue that that's being done out of convenience, right? Not because they want to, but maybe that may be so, but I don't know. Yeo malume. Taikonda yo. Eh. Classic road bike right there, I guess. you see a checkpoint like this and you know you're closer to the border or something, right? Good day, officer. Yeah. I don't know if that's a military or does have a gun. I think it's military. Oh. Yo! Yo, Malume! Oh my goodness, the landscape on my left is just, it's amazing! Do a mesh of yellow, right? Mauka. So cycling through this stretch just evoked a lot of wonderful memories with my father. He actually taught me how to ride a motorcycle. He started teaching me how to ride a motorcycle along this stretch. Many years ago, in the 90s it was. I was probably 9, maybe 10 years old or something. Yeah. Ifendukeni Palace, right? Maybe I should have driven up here. I guess get some proof here that I was here. So to the right is Feni, that's where His Royal Highness Senior Chief Mpezeni, as palace is. What I'm gonna do is just get some proof here that I was indeed here. People always want proof, right? How do we know you were here? Maybe you photoshopped that thing. Maybe. Maybe I did. Patricia Mpanza. Yeah, Malum. Eu. Katandala Primary School. See how many K's I've covered. Just to be certain. Yep. Ah, not much. 16 kilometers. Right. just realized I need to send a meeting here. Shoot! I'm wasting time here, but I thought I'd take a detour. I hope this is safe. Woohoo! Whoa! Looks like it is safe. Wow. there. You know light when he's tired, when he's no longer saying yeah, all right? Whoo! So the only consolation about cycling through this stretch is that I get to glide through most of this area I've covered, at least in the last two, maybe 3 Ks, right? I guess that's something to look forward to. Yo! Trying to hype myself up by saying yeah, what? Big ass truck behind. Just take a look at what I'm up against here. Score more? Yeah, Marume. Beautiful, eh? Yo! Hardworking people right there. I think I've ranted in the past about the efficacy or the effectiveness of this, but at least it's honest work. It's honest work. Call it what you may, you know, survival, yada yada yada, but it's honest, decent work. Half these people I bump into seem content, right? Happy. Yes, it's one would argue that it's true what they say about ignorance being bliss. None of these people care that you know, people living in these more affluent parts of the country go to Stakenico and Nando's. Yeah. Or if you go to Chicago's, right? And I'm just ranting here anyway. I thought you might want to appreciate the beauty I'm seeing along this stretch. Probably husband and wife on my right, wondering what they are faring there. Happy couple, perhaps. Don't know. Yeah, Malume. That's quite the load up there. Yo. Look at that, right? Morons on the road. And we have you on camera right here. Morons on the road. Yeah, Omalun. Yo, nipatari pa boda kutoka hapa, no?
Ah.
Eh, monga kutoka njinga ningafika ma minute anga.
Sikiga zo.
Eh?
Kama ni papu upi. Ah, hapa.
Eh? Ni papu upi? Cho pa boda.
Eh.
Oh. Nizo kwanza ni mpatari neo.
Ah,
we. Oh, okay, skoma.
Okay.
Eh. Ma? Awe na shoka pafu pla kwa chipata. Eh, mwaka tani. Mwaka bwe. Mwaka. Ona fika kala
eh.
Na zina kaza ati nipatari, so nizo mkosha ati nipatari ngawa kwa ati nipafu.
Ah, nipafu
kwa kishaka. Okay, skom. I was expecting it to be further away. Beautiful stuff. Oh, how I wish I'd carried my passport, right? And I've gone as far as Mchinji here. I haven't been to Malawi in years. I think the last time I was in Malawi was like 2009, I think, if not 2010, 2009 it was. Spent close to two, maybe 3 months there. Had a blast. Yeo! Ha! Mwami border post! I'm here! It's Sanjika Day Secondary School. Life is beautiful. Goodness, why did I leave my passport? boy, am I looking forward to gliding down these stretch on my way back. It's only a matter of time now. Hope this thing doesn't... It's about to go off. Simple life. I hope. Oh, sorry. I guess the ascent scared that little one. Or maybe I scared her. Probably look like a goblin with my helmet here. So I'm officially in Mwami right now. I'm actually surprised that there's no toll plaza right in between Chipata and Mwami. Very strange. I guess the reasoning could be that people would probably pay fees en route into Malawi or something, I don't know. Mwami. Hello. You know you're close to the border when you see a fleet of trucks. We made it. Mwami border. I probably would have covered this distance in record time if I was using the MXR. Oh wow. What's here?
Where is your home?
guess I'll make a return there. Thank you for telling me that there's no road. I don't know what they're constructing here, but it looks important, right? Fucked up, I left my passport. I haven't forgotten the cable here. Actually, I might have. I need to call myself a stupid person if I had, but. What, my passport? No mask on the border post, right? think I'm going to enjoy this trip back, I guess. Hello. Just wanted me to wave back at him, I suppose. I'm such an ass, I forgot my passport, right? I have no idea when next I'm coming back to this part of the country, probably towards the end of the year or something. It's gonna